Hello there and welcome to another Triplo AI video. Today I'm presenting you version 2.5.0 for desktops, and we have a lot to talk about. So without further ado, let me jump right into it. So the first thing is that we closed the beta for training. So now, from now on, training, each mine holds 200,000 tokens. This is a very, very large amount of tokens that you can add to your brains. It's equivalent to like two full romance books. Just for a reference, if you get like two Harry Potter books, you'll be able to add to one particular mine. So let me build one here. First, I'm going to paste all of the content of Triplo AI page, and I'll call this mine Triplo AI. And then you see that it's consuming 2,000 tokens, about 2,000 tokens, and I'll save it. Bear in mind that if you add all at once 200,000 tokens, it may take up to 10 minutes for your mind to be filled. Here I have my Triplo AI mind. I can activate it or directly on the main UI. And I also can add more content to it. Let me add it here. So I'm copying and then I'm adding some more 13,000 tokens. Notice that the window for updates is still 8,000 tokens. We are working on it, and this will be smaller on the next versions. Anyway, if you save it here, now you have a larger mine for your Triplo AI, in this case, content. So it's amazing. Very, very good. The second thing is that the cost for training is much smaller under the allowance now. It used to be paired with the chat or the prompting consumption, so one-to-one. And now training tokens costs a fifth of the regular prompting on the allowance. So what I'm telling you, feel free to add content to your minds and use them the best you want to. Another thing that changed is that we took automation out of beta also. It was working properly from a long time. And what we added is this possibility of turning off confirmation on automation. Some of you asked for that, and now you can do it. If you just switch this off, automations won't ask you for anything. So let me try it. This is a very, very foolish example. I just want to be sure that this won't ask me for confirmation. So I just wanted to be sure it worked. So what it did, it called the deliver webhooks info. This was the name of the automation. And it delivered the webhook results to the webhook. And the name was Triplo AI. Okay, perfect. It's working. Some of you are doing very interesting things with automation. And if you want to share this with us, go ahead. We are thankful for that. Let me jump into another one. So automation left the beta stage. Now, oh, this is a nice, very nice one. If I say, what you do in Rio in a 3-day trip? Here I got my answers. And now if I jump into the chat history, you see that we fixed that damn naming. So now you can see a Rio 3-day itinerary. You can edit it. Okay, you can, I believe this is like generating automatically the naming for it. AI is kind of slow, which is kind of sad. Okay, this should be working. And you can also delete it. Another thing that we changed, we added the copy button directly under the prompting thing. So you may copy this or continuing a chat, and notice that now chat mode is activated. Another thing that we changed was the device management UI UX. You see that we have been playing with this quite for a while. What's important for you to know is that the first device that you activate is the admin device. It may be mobile or a desktop. And then for each new device that is added under your licenses, you have to either approve or deny it. And you also have the ability to revoke the devices. If I, for example, revoke this mobile device, this will be gone until I reactivate it there. And you also have the ability of activating syncing between devices. In this case, if I turn this off, nothing that I built on my desktop will be shared with the other devices, or I can select if I want to share or not. Another small improvement for you, but really, really major for us, is better error handling. So we have been getting many questions about errors coming from OpenAI or OpenRouter or token exhaustion or the inability to consume APIs from OpenAI mainly. We are addressing this on error messages in a very, very direct and complete way now. Another thing, we fixed a small bug that was creating a mess on when you stop the content. Cool. We added this new auto select models. And for that, I'll have to activate my OpenAI key. Spare me a second. Now I have this new auto select model. And what it does, it considers mainly the number of tokens that you're using to either select GPT 3.5 16K or GPT 4 128K. This is like a minor thing on model selection, but if you are transiting between larger prompts and smaller prompts, this may be useful to you. We also added a new model on OpenRouter. So you can now use this Topi M7B32K. I didn't test it yet, but it, from what I read, feels very, very interesting. A large model, very cheap. I believe it's going for free now. We also improved the validation of the keys, either from OpenAI and OpenRouter. And we improved the security of keys, mainly the allowance keys. I hope you enjoyed. Take care. Bye-bye.